Hello, the students of HS Second Year. I welcome you all to our SS College YouTube channel. In my last class, I have discussed the colligative properties. So there are four types of colligative properties: lowering of vapor pressure, elevation of boiling point, depression of freezing point, and osmosis. And today I will discuss elevation of boiling point. Now, what is boiling point? We know that boiling point of a liquid is defined as the temperature at which its vapor pressure equal to the atmospheric pressure. So this is our boiling point. Now, boiling point of a solution is always more than that of its pure solvent. Now, if we plot a graph between temperature and vapor pressure, then this is the curve of a solvent and this is the curve of a solution. So we know that the vapor pressure of a solution containing non-volatile solute is less than that of pure solvent, and it means that the vapor pressure of a solution will become equal to the vapor pressure of the pure solvent, and that is why this is the reason that boiling point of a solution is higher than that of the boiling point of a pure solvent. So if T1 is this and T2 is this, then we know that elevation in boiling point will be elevation in boiling point will be our T2 minus T1, that is our del TB. That is our del TB. This del TB is the elevation in boiling point. Again we know that our del TB is directly proportional to molarity of the solution. Here M dash is the molarity of the solution. Now we know that from this our del TB is equal to some constant into M dash. This constant we can write it KB. So here del TB is elevation in boiling point. This M dash is molarity of the solution, and this KB is molal elevation constant. Molal elevation constant or ebullioscopic constant. So from this we can write our del TB is directly proportional to del P. Again, we can write del TB is directly proportional to del P. Del P. Where we can write PS, that is P naught minus PS is proportional to X solute. From Raoult's law, you know Raoult's law? From Raoult's law, we can write P0 minus Ps is directly proportional to X solute. So we can write this del P. Del P is proportional to X solute. X solute. So del TB is equal to, we can write some constant into X solute. So from this, we can write our X solute is equal to this N divided by this N plus this N. This is the number of solute, and this is number of solute, and this is number of solvent. So we can write our X solute is equal to mole fraction. And for dilute solution, we know that X solute is, that is for dilute solution, this one is negligible, so we can write our X solute is equal to this N by N, that is small N by capital N. So we can write our X solute is equal to N by N. Again, for dilute solution, we can write our X solute is equal to N divided by L, and we can write W by capital M. W by capital M, where W is amount of solvent and this M is molecular mass. So from this also we can write our del TB, that is elevation in boiling point, is equal to K into capital M into N by W. So this is another relation, and these relations are very much important for solving different types of problems. Again, let W gram of non-volatile solute is dissolved in W gram of the solvent. Then we can write our this M is equal to, small m is equal to 1000 into KB into small w divided by small m into capital W. So this is also one of the important relation, del TB. So elevation in boiling point. Lastly, we get this equation, and this equation is very much important, that del TB is equal to 1000 into KB into W divided by M into capital W. So by applying this equation, we can solve different types of problems. Suppose today I will give you a question, that is, you write, suppose this one, suppose acetone boils at, the question is acetone boils at 56 degree centigrade, and a solution of 1.4 gram of an organic solid in 30 gram of acetone boils at 56.2 degree centigrade. If our KB for acetone per 100 gram is 16.5 degree centigrade, calculate the mass of organic acid. Now see the question, and first of all, for solving this type of problems, first of all you read once or twice the question, and then you write what are the given. So solution here, what are given? First, our equation will be M is equal to 1000 into KB into small w divided by our del TB into capital W. So this is the equation, and by using this equation we can solve the problem. Now here, what are given? First of all, del TB is here, one is 56 degree centigrade, another is 56.2 degree centigrade. So it will be T2 minus T1, so 56.2 minus 56 degree centigrade, that is 0.2 degree centigrade, del TB is given. Next is your W, this is small W, 1.4. So small W is 1.4 gram. Now capital W is here, it is given 30 gram. So capital W is 30 gram, small W is 1.4, del TB is 56.2 minus 56 equal to 0.2 degree. So our KB is equal to, KB is equal to what? Boyle said this and this, 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 this. So our KB is equal to what? KB is equal to 16.5 degree centigrade. So these are the things given, and you put the values in the formula, then you will get the answer. And you do the problem in your home, and the answer will be approximately 385. So this is your answer. So is it clear to you? Next is depression of freezing point. Now what is freezing point? Do you know what is freezing point? Now, freezing point of a substance is defined as the temperature at which it just changes into the solid state and the temperature at which both solid and liquid can coexist. So this is the kind also like this, like the previous one. So this is A, this is B, this is C, this is temperature, this is vapor pressure, Vp, and next is so this is our liquid solvent. This AC is the curve for liquid solvent. Liquid solvent. And this one is C. This one is F1. Suppose this one is E. This one is D. And this is for your solution. So this is vapor pressure. So like elevation of boiling point, the curve of depression of freezing point is also like this. The graph is in between vapor pressure and temperature. And this is for liquid solvent and this is for solution. So from this, depression in freezing point, we can write the depression in freezing point is equal to if it is T and if it is T naught, then it will be T naught minus T, that is del Tf, that is the depression of freezing point. Similarly, we can write our del Tf is proportional to m dash. So del Tf is equal to some constant into m dash, and this Kf is our molar depression constant or molar cryoscopic constant. What cryoscopic constant? And similar to our elevation of boiling point, we can also get another equation which is also important for solving different types of problems, that are our m is equal to 1000 into Kf into small w divided by del Tf into capital W. So this is the equation of depression of freezing point, and by using this we can also solve different types of problems. So this much for today. Thank you.